midongo senu ko. Bene mi adu apema. Si ojrado dinami. Trotu hehe siame, miaje apeto yume, dota Jerusalem, kupu ye velia. Vakpo godre wucha adi agbemavo viomi gavo migbekeke amejijo epe beble kle juju mihei ngoteko. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forever. Amen. Shall we please be seated? My honor to invite the rector of the Global Theological Seminary in the person of Reverend Dr. Komi Hyangbe to lead us in the opening prayer and the affirmation of our faith in the Creed.
Mia aiji bakple gbedodora atakpe na apeto lepa menveve lepa metakpokpota e mia cho egbe powo na ha adasini. We are beginning with a time of thanksgiving to God for his loving kindness and for his mercies. He has brought us from far and near, and this man and woman before us, he has brought them from very far to this day. Want to thank God for his grace that has brought us this far. Mi aji adakpe na apeto repa manu veve sike plomiva afi miru egbe minamia adugbara fo mi adakpe na kafo mi do reji mi subo labana wenye fia wenye fia. We give you all glory, we give you all praise, we give you all honor. We thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your kindness. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we honor you. Lord, we adore you and say you are God and there is no God besides you, Lord. I want to thank God for the nation of Ghana, for the peace that he has endowed us with. Let us thank him for even taking us through, almost through, the COVID pandemic. As a church, as far as I know, we haven't lost any, and we want to thank God for that. I don't think even any of our members was afflicted in any way. We want to thank God for protecting us. Creates a lot of anxiety. Miado Barabe, Yehua Pashina Noma, Oklomia Toma Bobwe, praying for peace before, during, and after the 2020 elections. Let us pray. Lord, you protect us. Bless us, Father, we pray. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we pray your blessings upon this nation, Lord. Give us your peace, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Let us pray that the Lord himself will choose the right leaders for us as a nation. Leaders who will lead us in justice. Leaders who will lead us through self-sacrifice and seek the welfare of all. Let us pray. Lord, be the right leaders, O God, for our nation. We ask in the name of Jesus. Bless us, Lord, be the right leaders, O God. May we continue to pray for the Global Evangelical Church. Let us pray for our Synod Committee Executive, the moderator, Synod Clerk, male and female presbyters. Let's ask for God's wisdom and leading for them. Pray for our presbytery chairman. Let's pray for our pastors and evangelists, all who play leadership roles, our presbyters, that the Lord will endow us with wisdom from above. Presbytery chairman, sofo kata, presbyter, mayo kata ko, eklona mila hama mamia choa da sina peto, nena jifonunya, bemia acho aklo, efan hao. Okay. Mlaiba mia cho, ndi afe. Dudu adasina afeto be eyanto nanozima efu gwo kwe na klomi nya bia fo yayira de novio ke jiwa acho do adasina gba nya bia amisisi toke now. Let us pray for the day's service. Let's pray for the pastors to be who will be commissioned this morning. mafufu mi cho akpedada kple kafukafu na o elabena wenye nuwo kata pa gomajela e we wo ro ro nuwo kata nchi e egbengeka ya ha yehowa e wo ro ro ngeka nchi kemi cho na ukata la sio madam yehowa ba wonto na ajango e na klomia tuma wo ya yira klo unti ko kwe na anomia ji nye da pe no kafu e yesu kristo pon koma amen Affirming our faith with the Apostles' Creed.
Yedakpena Osofo Dr. Hyangbe, Rector, Global Theological Seminary. We shall proceed very quickly, take the readings for today. And we have Professor Remy Ladosraku, the male presbyter on the Synod Committee Executive, to do that for us, both in English and Ebe. Let's receive him.
Maunya echo Luka fa agbalama Luka fa nyanyue tawi ene Mia klecho kpikwi adre vasere wi enelia Luka fa nyanyue tawi ene kpikwi adre vasere wi enelia Aye, esi wo jesi, alesi amekpekpeawo tia nɔƒe gbãtɔwo la, edo lo na wo gblɔ bena, ne ame aɖe kpe wo va srɔ̃ɖeƒe la, meganɔ nɔƒe gbãtɔ o, ɖewohĩ wokpe ame ŋkuta wu wo ve, eye ame si kpe mia kple ame ma la, Ava gblɔ na wo bena, tsɔ nɔwoƒe na ame sia, eye ekema ade asi nɔƒe mletɔ tsɔtsɔ me kple ŋukpe. Ke boŋ ne wokpe wo la, yi ɖanɔ nɔƒe mletɔ bena, ne ame si kpe wo va la, agblɔ na wo bena, xɔ te yi Plota, ekema anye bubu na wo le ame siwo katã le kplɔa ŋuti la ƒe ŋkume. Elabena ame sia ame si ado eɖokui ɖe dzi la, woabɔbɔe ɖe anyi eye ame si bɔbɔ eɖokui ɖe anyi la, woadoe ɖe dzi. Eye wògblɔ na ame si kpee hã bena, Ne eɖo ŋdɔ alo fiekplɔ la, megayɔ exɔwo alo nɔviwo alo wo ƒometɔwo alo hawovi kesinɔtɔwo o, bena woawo hã nagakpe wo eye woaɖo eteƒe na wo o. Ke boŋ, ne eɖo kplɔ la, yɔ ame dahewo, nuwametɔwo, bunowo nku agbato eye na zuya irame esina neke mele wo si be wado etefe na wo o nguti ke wado etefe na wo le amejojo ofe chitre chichi lame amen. The scripture text this morning is taken from the Gospel of Luke, Luke chapter 14. We read from verse 7 to 14. Luke chapter 14, 7 to 14. So he told a parable to those who were invited when he noted how they chose the best places, saying to them, when you are invited by anyone to a wedding feast, do not sit down in the best place, lest one more honorable than you be invited by him. And he who invited you and him come and say to you, give place to this man, and then you begin with shame to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit down in the lowest place, so that when he who invited you comes, he may say to you, friend, go up higher. Then you will have glory in the presence of those who sit at the table with you. For whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. Then he also said to him who invited him, when you give a dinner and or a supper, do not ask your friends, your brothers, your relatives, nor rich neighbors, lest they also invite you back.
Bethel Revival to lead us. It's time to praise the Lord. As we do, we want to take our thanksgiving offering, and the ushers will come around to take the offering. So don't worry at all, you will not move from where you are. Miape ushers uava aho miape akweda nunanao. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Shall we rise? O nyamiba ye iwayeta ni awu ye mamide yineti betiwa ye
Yeah. tutuku Onya mika siye ye kafu wo ye shira wo na ye tutuku
Onya mika siye ye kafu wo ye shira wo na ye tutuku
Ye si onya mika siye ye kafu wo ye shira wo na ye tutuku
Onya mika siye ye kafu wo ye shira wo na ye tutuku
Lift up your voice and begin to bless the name of the Lord. It deserves all the glory, it deserves all the praise. Lift up your voice and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Neme tonko no siwo nye mawu onamla.
Lift your voice.
Akbeko madane.
He's a good God.
Neme donko, he has been so good to us. No siwo, ye mawu onamla abeko madane. Neme donko, no siwo,
ye mawu onamla.
For all that you've done, I want to give you all the glory, Lord.
Nemeto, nemeto, no siwo, ye mawo,
lift your voice and begin to bless His holy name.
Good,
Father, we honor you. You deserve all the glory, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Shall we put our hands together once again? Shall we appreciate the Lord for His grace? Preaching the sermon this morning is the moderator of the Global Evangelical Church, the Right Reverend Dr. Seto Okwajo Ofori. May I humbly request that we rise and welcome him to the sermon.
Praise the Lord. Please be seated. Hallelujah. Thanks again to the Lord, God Almighty, for making it possible for us to gather today. We are here to commission 33 people, one female and 32 males, into the holy ministry as probationers. Let's just draw one or two thoughts from the passage read. The passage came from Luke chapter 14, verses 7 to 14. Let us pray. Father, you have always opened our eyes, our hearts, to your words, because it is your will that we follow in your words. Do it again this morning in Jesus' name. Amen. Luke chapter 14, verses 17 to 14, deals with two proverbs of Jesus Christ, parables, the parable of the wedding feast and the parable of the banquet. This morning, I want us to look at the parable of the wedding feast, just very briefly. Jesus Christ was invited by a Pharisee, who was also a ruler, to dine, to eat. So Jesus went. So you can see that Jesus Christ was social, was a sociable person. So he went. And when he saw people coming in, the way they were struggling for position, he spoke a parable. Hence the theme for today is, wait for your promotion. Often in everyday life at our workplaces, you'll be told to work on your promotion, work out your promotion, yes. There are times you do that, but there are times you also have to wait for your promotion. So Jesus spoke this parable, telling them that when you are invited to a place, take a low seat. And then the one who invites you comes and says, no, this is not your place. Go and sit up there. Jesus explained that it was not okay, it was not right for you to begin to get the highest seat. Because if you did that, and somebody else, because you don't know who else has been invited, someone else, it's supposedly more important than you, comes, they will say, oh, Mr. So-so-and-so or Madam so-so-and-so, can you step down? And you will be disgraced. So the emphasis of Jesus Christ was and is on humility. In the parable, the one has been invited by a master, just as you have been invited into ministry. And the person came out of the person's own volition, just as you have also come. But when you come, it takes people. Some of those people may just be very seemingly low people, to make you progress, to make you reach the heights. It's just as he said, if you are invited, if the ushers were doing their work well, then it's the usher who may be a nobody who will tell you, come and sit here. And say, oh no, sit here rather. So there's the need for us to be patient, to wait for our promotion. Yesterday I told you, that there is the need for you to live and serve under authority. Very soon you'll be commissioned. And when you are commissioned, then you get more power and authority. You get a position power. Yesterday we said, power is the ability to do work. So you get position power, you'll be able to do certain things more. Even the fact that you have been trained enables you to do certain things that hitherto you were not able to do. But let not this power get into your mind. You're also going to have authority. Authority is the right to do. After you have been commissioned, you would have the right to do certain things that hitherto you did not have the right to do. And people will look at you differently. But there is the need for you to humble yourselves. Calm down. See, power comes from above, but is granted from below. I'm going to explain to you. Power from above and power from below. You may be called, commissioned. Your call is from God. You are commissioned by the leadership of the church. But it is the people you are going to lead that are going to help you to fit into the position that you have been given. Power comes from above, but it is granted from below. Let me give you a biblical example and you will understand. Let me give you the example of David. Now, if you read the Bible very carefully, God said David was a man after his own heart. If God says that you are a man after his own heart, what else do you need? You just have to march on. But after God said that and he was anointed for the first time, David had to go through several things. After the death of Saul, we are told, David asked God, God, where should I go? And God said, go to Hebron. When he went to Hebron, then the men of Judah, they could just be ordinary people. Men of Judah came and anointed him king. God said, you are a man after my own heart. But it was the granting came from below, power from below. It is those down there that lift you up to where God wants you to be. And so if you go to the congregation and you begin to lord it over them, you begin to insult them, you begin to speak to them anyhow, you will be surprised with your degrees. Maybe you are posted and you are serving in a village, maybe like my village. You would be surprised the things that you face. Because power is granted from below. It is those down there who make you who you are. If you were a mother, you gave birth to 1, 2, 3 children. The children are the people who make you feel a mother. They call you mother. Power comes from above, but it is often granted from below. And that's why you don't have to insult people. And that's why you have to be humble. On the heels of this, let me say one or two things even concerning our politics. Very soon we'll be going to vote. Is power from below? You want to tell me no? Power from below. Look, if we wake up that morning to go and vote, and then we see in the clouds, it is written the name of the person who will be president. Even then, people have to go and vote for that person or for some other person. It will still come from below. So power doesn't just come from above. You throw your weight about. And that is why for us in Ghana, when politicians begin to shoot people, they begin to insult, they tell this ethnic community, you don't belong. They should remember that power comes from below. If the president were to engage me in a chat, 5 minutes chat, just that, one of the things I would tell him is that there is the need for an apology for some of these things. Because power comes from below. If the apology doesn't come today, it will come tomorrow. I'll tell him to apologize on behalf of his children. A father, sometimes fathers must apologize on behalf of their children. Because power comes from below. You can't begin to deride the people, to insult them, and then next time you think that, oh, they should elevate you. It doesn't come that way. So if you are a leader, if you are a politician, you are a pastor, you are a worker, you are put at a position there. Know that you will not just remain there. And it is the people under you that make you fit into that position. So this comes to you as pastors. When you even go to preach, don't begin first by reading out your, how do you call it? Your curriculum vitae. I did this. I did that. Oh, once upon a time I did that. Just come humbly. Let even people initially assume that, oh, this person, what has he got to give? And then after 5 minutes, 10 minutes of your preaching, of your teaching, they will say, hey, this is a man of God. This is a woman of God. Power comes from below. So if you leave this place and somebody asks you what has the moderator said, tell them moderator says, power is from above, but it is granted from below. This is why you should not look down upon people, the people you are leading. If you do, things will not move out, will not move on well with you the way you expect. Yes, you have power, you have authority, but use that authority well. Lead people. Be faithful in your leadership. This year and next year, 2 years, we have the theme Faithful Stewardship. And stewardship entails so much. You are called to be stewards, leading people. To be a steward is to be in charge, to take care of that which has been entrusted to you. I was sharing some thoughts with Synod Committee members, saying that when you look at the theme Faithful stewardship. There are a number of things that are involved. I started sharing stewardship of your formation. You have to be a steward of that, where you were born. If you were born in a village, Aveme, You have to accept it that that is where you were born. You were born in Mafia Vakbedome. You must accept that that is where you come from. First of all, then you are ready for your stewardship. Your mother was a farmer. Your father was a farmer who brought you up. You have to accept that. If there are any things negative, then now you can work on those things. It's important that we be stewards of your formation. Be stewards of your body, soul, and spirit. Spirit first. Accept Jesus as your personal savior. That your soul will be secured. But your body is also important. Care for your body. Eat well, eat at the right time. Don't go for revivals and then you come home and then you are eating at 10 p.m. that you have cast out all the demons. Care for yourself and teach others to care for their bodies. It's part of the stewardship that has been entrusted into your hands. Tell your young ladies that they don't need the largest breasts and the biggest, Buttocks to be able to get the right partners. Tell them. It's stewardship of the body. People don't have to tattoo their bodies, you know, for anything. I met a young man and he tattooed his body and I asked, oh, why? He said, something happened to me some time ago and I've just tattooed my body so that I can remember. And then another thing happened another time, so I tattooed my body. So when a third thing happens, he would tattoo part of his body. If a fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh happened, he would tattoo his body. Let people care for their bodies. You have a black body. Teach them to be stewards. These are some of the things we'll be going through throughout the year, the 2 years. Be stewards of your gifts and your talents. Spiritual gifts and your natural talents. Very often Christians have thrown away their natural talents. We only talk about spiritual gifts. Both come from God. Natural and spiritual both come from God. Be stewards of your talents. Be stewards of the community, of the corporate culture of your people. In which case, vote. We are going to vote soon. Encourage people to go and vote. Speak positively to them. Tell them to be faithful in the community. And tell them that when the day of voting comes, whoever comes out as the head, as president, should be accepted. It's part of stewardship. We must also be stewards of the environment. If you travel a little around, you went out somewhere, some to certain places, even in Africa, and you came back to Ghana, in your mind you feel bad because you realize that we have lots of rubbish around. It's the duty of the pastor to teach people to be stewards of their environment. And then we'll be stewards of our resources. Resources, the things God has given you. These are some of the things you'll be taking people through. Read your Bible very well. Let your teaching be biblical. Be prayerful. Carry people along. Carry the weak along. This, the effect of COVID-19 has started. 1 year, 2 years, the effect will be there. You will begin to see that hardship has begun to creep into the lives of people. You are to encourage them. Encourage them. Encourage your members. Live lives that will give glory to God. Be an example at any time. And carry your family along. Carry your spouse along. When you do these things, your promotion will come. your promotion will come. You may be posted to a very remote village, but when you do these things very well, your promotion will come. So work out your promotion, yes, but wait for your promotion. May the Lord strengthen you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord protect you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Ndia melegboglobe. Nema uyowa. Amewe ya wobe wanya meike maudibe nanye. No jivi kura. Evi enyonu ojivi. Deka eveton. Ne devi miyo me yo ube mama. Dada. Mami. No me yo we. Eme ya yo. Mereke ma yo. Evi miyo ji. Yo we ya wo dada na. Ta ame si ame elebe ne boboro kwe. Ne bu ame. Amewe duwa mereji. Amo, yaya wobe fike maube na anoi. Ya wano. Da asofu, bebe amo, kloge miye bona. Mikula amo. Ndi amele boblon hanbe, efe ime, cho septemba, penke ke gbanto kaka fe vela. Mia fe... Enyatia enye honuvinu tefe wola e mi dibe mi tegbede honuvinyenyeji honuvinyenye lo agbefa pade si adede me wa fe megbe nono wo gbodo megbe nono e wo ha megbe nono e lo de si adede me be mi enye honuvinu tefe wola o Damiano Clalo, be me a fear amo, be one year on view. Ekema, me a pochichi deji, me a behama a pochichi deji, duco a pochichi deji. Me di Yehoa fe yaira, Yehoa fa me bono no. Yehoa fe ame unti koko. Yehoa fe mota tada mengo. Yehoa fe nunye, chocho doa koname. Yehoa fe nu tefe wowo Yehoa fe nyi didina me Yehoa fa me yayira me dina mi ndia e abale ike me gble na mia mia me bla ton voton ike ediwa dasido egba amareke ma gele ma o le moreke ji o Yehoa ne nye mia pe nuse le Yesu Kristo fe nkome. Amen. Mia do beda. Afeto mi dakpe de wunyata. Eyo edibe mi asega ke. Mi te un glow le gapopo ya o ma afeto fonu na mi na cho pe na mi. Wa men veve ne gbagu de mi ajile Yesu Kristo fan kome. Amen.
Akpe mieda akpe na mau e mieda akpe hana miape e hango nola miape moderator mau na irami adongu semi e miazole nyamao me e efe vide nakplo miao miapafe ple miape duko ple heble bo katado amen abale imiegble arei Imie kole dowo nye gapopo ameve, gapopo de kava iye koto gapopo de ka. Ta mia hudu, be mia tengwa wunu, le wona, asida dade sofo uji pe wona vomegbea, sino donu no ha, gado donu no ha bubude, ike haji wada sido egbea. Ma nyenu didi ya oga ke okata ofofu ta mi afofu ona deo mawo abaleke mi epo le mi afe agbale tata jio ta mi ajopo ato enyele aji eye mi aho osofo alomi aho mi anovi azu sofo egbe Mie demenao, e mie demia ga demena. Habli bokata, bede reyirita, mi matenga honu chongu, abale ko lagbala meo. Ake mi anya open ko, kple suku suwe ike ode, ike wo anye osofo, nububu deka alo eve ike kudongwa, mi atek bede e ya haji. Ke mi ame yo si agbala lea, ne mi eduo apemea, mi agaten wakle ope, suku denyao hamegbe nono ble efi yoke wocho ta mi akwe nami nenema azone mi eyo mi anovi wwa ameve yoke mi be wakplo wodo avakpo wona tepela woha wachitre ke mane mi wame mato voko wano anyi e anye mi ape mo ikeji mi ato adejesi mi apafi avava. As we call the names of the candidates, the two special guests that they have invited should also please rise along so we can recognize them. As I have said, we just want to touch on salient lines in the profile. Thank you very much. So we go. Mr. Adeponu Edem Kwamivi. Mr. Edem Kwame V. Adeponu was born on 21st March 1984 at Benali, Wawa in Togo. Well, he served the local congregation in very many capacities, including becoming the local evangelist. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He is married to Mrs. Mause Ablavi Adeponu, and they are blessed with two children. Mr. Harrison Wolasi Adoblosu. Mr. Harrison Wolasi Adoblosu was born on the 3rd of August 1970 at Lokba Klepo, his hometown. And in the local congregation, he served at one time as a catechist. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He is married to Mrs. Miriam Joyce Adoblosu. They are blessed with five children. Mr. Elom Yao Adome. Mr. Elom Yao Adome was born on the first day of July 1976 at KJB Akan, but hails from Mafi Gidikpoe. In the local congregation, he served as catechist for 20 years. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. Mr. Adome is married to Mrs. Love Adome. They are blessed with three children. Mr. Cornelius Kwame Agba. He was born on the 19th of August 1989 and hails from Agba Kope. In the local congregation, he was a Bible study coordinator and also into music. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. Cornelius is yet to marry. Gakewa for lekpeji tamega no kpodo da bube monu popo de kaba suisio. Mr. James Mawiena Agbeko. Mela me yoke jamio yo mekpolo alo le chitwe chiafea. Okay, all right. Mr. James Mawiena Agbeko was born on the 5th of March 1981 in Accra and hails from Chibu Awudome. He was the youth president, including many other services he rendered to the local congregation. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He is married to Mrs. Vivian Agbeko, and they are blessed with three children. Engineer Patrick Achu Kwabla Agbemabiase. He was born on the 20th of September 1977 and hails from Anyako. In the local congregation, he was a church session member and assistant secretary. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He is married to Mrs. Belinda Esenam Atieku Agbemabiase. Mr. Simon Agbenafa, he was born on the 15th of December 1975 and hails from Adaklupoji. He was the local catechist. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. Agbenafa is married to Mrs. Grace Aram Agbenafa. They are blessed with three children. Mr. Paul Yao Agbo. He was born on the 18th of November 1968 at Aduto, his hometown, and was a full-time catechist in his local congregation. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Reverend Mrs. Patricia Akpenetegbe Agbo. They are blessed with two children. Oh, mi apete mi daseji. Obo ma ku akpe o ma dole o. Ta mi ana mi nose mask wa meto mi ga ko pere ke hele fifi la un. Mr. Eric Ago Note. He was born on the 1st of December 1980 in Accra. In the local congregation, he was the acting president of the youth ministry, including other committees he served on. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Solis Ago Note. They are blessed with two children. Mr. Michael Kobla Agboada. He was born on the 10th of January 1984 at Anglogan. In the local congregation, he was a local evangelist and a member of the evangelism team. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He is married to Mrs. Juliana Agboada. They are blessed with three children. Mr. Louis Mensah Agbenyefia. He was born on the 1st.
Oh, Emma Krachefia be Okpa Mewa Meve.
Mr. Louis Mensah Agbenyefia was born on the 1st of April 1975 at Hlevi. He was the youth president. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Gloria Emefa Agbenyefia. They are blessed with three children. Mr. David Kwajo Ami Lecha. He was born on the 9th of March 1981 at Adaklu Helekwe. He was a session member and a Bible study teacher and a lay preacher. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. Mr. Ami Lecha is married to Mrs. Gladys Awinyam Ami Lecha. Mr. Francis Kwajo Aivi. He was born on the 28th of August 1985 at Uwe, his hometown. He was a session secretary and served in many other areas. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Eve Valentina Aivi. They are blessed with two boys. Mr. Nelson Kwame Azuma. He was born on the 7th of July 1972 at Tanyigbe, his hometown. He was the catechist. And he applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Gladys Kafui Hianji Azuma, and they are blessed with three children. Mr. Vincent Setou Kwaku Bansan. He was born on the 28th of December 1983 at Pekijake, his hometown. He was a home cell leader and a Bible study coordinator in the local congregation. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Brines. Is that the pronunciation? Asiome Bansa. They are blessed with a son. Mr. Frank Amenuvela Doku. He was born on the 26th of September 1971 at Anyinawase Awudome, his hometown. He was the catechist. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Gifty Mawienamme Ajo Doku. Mr. Michael Kwasi Kudaya. He was born on the 6th of October 1974 in his hometown at TRV. He served as the head office evangelist for a number of years. He also applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Ethel Akpene Kudaya, and they are blessed with two children. Mr. Dela Ledi. He was born on the 20th of October 1987 at Mission Tove in Togo, his hometown. He was a Bible study leader in his local congregation. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He is yet to marry. Mr. Carlos Gaglo Zu. He was born on the 6th of June 1985 at Abutiakle, but hails from Abutiateti. In his local congregation, he was the youth president and served in several other capacities. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted, and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Jigbodi Ama Achrim Gaglozu. Mr. Stephen Kwame Badago. He was born on the 13th of March 1971 and hails from Ehi. In his local congregation, he was a session secretary and catechist at one time. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Esther Balansua Badago. They are blessed with a boy. Mr. Godwin Bomita. I have forgiven you because you are from this congregation. Mr. Godwin Bomita was born on the 21st of August 1982 at Pig Farm in Accra. In the local congregation, he served in several areas, including children's ministry president. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Vivian Esinam Bomita. They are blessed with two children. Mr. Daniel Senaya Ogojo. He was born on the 26th of September 1969 at Saviepe Bogame, his hometown. In the local congregation, he was a session member and played other key roles. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted, and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Doris Mante Abuajiwa. They have five children. Mr. Godwin Kwame Etonam Pogo. He was born on the 17th of September 1983 at Ehi. In the local congregation, he also worked with the children's ministry and at one time the ministry's secretary and president. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Mause Pogo. Mr. Eliezer Sefako Nwade. He was born on the 6th of May 1978 at Mache, his hometown. In the local congregation, he was the youth district evangelist, local evangelist, and the district session secretary. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. Mr. Nwade is yet to marry. Mr. Prosper Nyamado. He was born on the 20th of June 1970 at Keta, but hails from Anyako. In the local congregation, he was at one time session executive member and served in other areas. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Ophelia Nyamado. They are blessed with three children. Mr. Augustine Sichope, sir. He was born on the 29th of March 1984 at Amfueta Chebi, his hometown. He was a youth leader and a lay preacher. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Agustina Maulawe, sir. They are blessed with a child. Mr. Andrews Kwame Sewonu. He was born on the 18th of November 1989 and hails from Mafikpeibo. In his congregation, he was the catechist and the session secretary at one time. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He will very soon get married. Mr. Simon Kwashi Sechuafia. He was born on the 14th of May 1967 and hails from Anglogan. In his local congregation, he was the catechist. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Esther Jijonu Sechuafia. They are blessed with three children. Mrs. Love Akos Srebi. She was born on the 9th of May 1971 at Mafikumasi, but hails from Voja. In his local congregation, she was at one time church session secretary. She applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted, and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. She is married to Reverend Elias Rebi. They are blessed with a daughter. Mr. Moses Kwasi Tokujo. He was born on the 4th of March 1973 at Galosota. In his local congregation, he was a lay preacher, secretary to the evangelism committee and other committees. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary, also yet to marry. Mr. Christian Kojo Voleto. He was born on the 18th of October 1985 at Dabala. In his local congregation, he was a cell leader, presbytery youth president, and a lay preacher. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary, married to Mrs. Agatha Honam Voleto, and they are blessed with a child. Mr. Kingsley Yesu Lagbe. He was born on the 28th of May 1985 at Garian, Tripoli in Libya, but hails from Mafi Abude Kumasi. In his local congregation, as well as the National Church, he was at one time head office evangelist. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. He's married to Mrs. Gloria Gotslav Yesu Lagbe, and they are blessed with a daughter. The last but not least, Mr. Faith Zanu. He was born on the 21st of July 1988 at Angloga. In his local congregation, he was Sunday school teacher and president. He applied to join the pastoral ministry, was accepted and trained at the Global Theological Seminary. Mr. Zanu is yet to marry. Shall we now put our hands together for all of them? Niaho kata kle akwe. Thank you very much. We shall now ask their spouses to resume their seats very quickly. Spouses to resume their seats very quickly. Thank you very much. Now, about 10. Right, Reverend Dr. Moderator, I present to you 33 candidates trained from the Global Theological Seminary to be commissioned. Thank you.
In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the King and Head of the Church, who being ascended on high, has given gifts unto men for the building up of the body of Christ, we are made here by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church to appoint these brethren as preachers of the gospel and probationers for the holy ministry and to license them to administer the sacraments. I will require of them to take their vow. They have already signed copies of the vow, so they know the content, but I will go through. You have responded to the call to be a preacher of the gospel. You are to declare before God and the congregation your intention to undertake this holy office. Will you, with the help of the Holy Spirit, faithfully discharge the duties of this office, consecrate your whole time and strength to the service of our Lord in the church, being at his disposal whenever he calls you, willing to suffer hardship, and if need be, even death for his sake? Will you be subject to the Lord, to the duly constituted authorities of the Global Evangelical Church, seek its unity and peace, and cherish a spirit of brotherhood with all the followers of the Lord? In keeping with this high calling, will you be diligent to frame and fashion your life and the life of your household according to the teaching of Christ and make yourself and them as much as lies in you wholesome examples to the flock of Christ? If you are willing to do these things, then your response will be, yes, I will, God be my helper. I will now require of you to come one after the other for the charge. Edem Kwamivi Adeponu, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the ministry. May the Lord himself break the bow of the enemy before you, in Jesus' name. Amen. Harrison Wolasi Adoblusu, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the ministry. May the Lord be your strength, the strength of your life. You shall not be afraid. Amen. Elom Yao Adome, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry. Yea, though you walk through the valley of shadows of death, you will fear no evil, for the Lord is with you. Amen. Cornelius Kwame Agba, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the ministry. Blessed are you. Walk in the counsel of the living God, and he will strengthen you in ministry. Amen. James Mawiena Agbeko, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the ministry. Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, no evil shall be allowed to befall you. Amen. Patrick Achu Kwabla Agbemabiese, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. May the Lord enable you to serve. May he bless you. May he bless your bread and water. May he bless you and keep you out of sickness. In Jesus' name, amen. Simon Agbenafa, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. Delight thyself in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Amen. Paul Yao Agbo, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day. I commission you into the holy ministry. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not on your understanding. Amen. Eric Agunote, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. See, I have this day set over nations that you root out and pull down and build. May the Lord be your strength. Amen. Michael Kwabla Agbuada, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. Go forth in this strength and be fruitful servant for the Lord. Amen. Louis Mensah Agbenyefia. Amenyefia. Louis Mensah Amenyefia. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. Behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall harm you. In Jesus' name, amen. David Kojo Amilecha, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. You are crucified with Christ. Live for Christ, and the Lord strengthens you in ministry. Amen. Francis Kojo Ayivi, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and petition, let your requests be known unto God. May God bless you. Amen. Mr. Nelson Kwame Azuma, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry. Be salt, be light, shine into darkness. May the Lord be your strength in ministry. Amen. Vincent Seto Koku Bansa, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry this day. May God give you enablement and make you abound by grace in all his sufficiency. In Jesus' name, amen. Frank Amenuvela Doku. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry. The Lord your God is in your midst. He is mighty to save you at all times. Amen. Michael Kwasi Kudaya, in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. Tell those who are afraid that their God is with them. In Jesus' name, amen. Carlos Gagluzu Lady Dela. Yes. Dela Lady. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. The Lord your God will give you fresh enablement. May he sanctify you through and through for ministry in Jesus' name. Amen. Carlos. Carlos Gagluzu, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into ministry this day. Do you not know the Lord your God? He is the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not faint, he will not grow weary. He will strengthen you. Amen. Stephen Kwame Badago. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. Fear not, for the Lord is with you. Do not be dismayed, for he is your God, to lead and to strengthen you. Amen. Godwin Bomita. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. He's the one who gives power to the faint. He will strengthen you in ministry. Amen. Daniel Sena Yao Gojo. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord protect you. Trust in him, and he will lead you. Amen. Godwin Etonam Kwame Bogo. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Eliezer Sefako Nwade. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Walk with him in all faithfulness. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. prosper Nyamado in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry. The Lord will cause your enemies who rise against you to be defeated before you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Augustine, Sichope, Sa. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry. Fear not, for the Lord is with you. Do not be dismayed. He is your God to lead you. Amen. Andrews, Kwame Sewonu, in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry. The Lord is your shepherd. If you walk through the valleys of shadows of death, you will fear no evil, because he is with you to lead you in Jesus' name. Amen. Simon Kwesi Kwashi Sechuafia. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you today into the holy ministry. The Lord is your rock and fortress. He is your deliverer. He is your refuge. He will take care of you. Amen. Love Akos Srebi, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. May the Lord be your strength to guide and protect you, to break the way ahead of you in all things and at all times, in Jesus' name. Amen. Moses Kwasi Tokujo. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into the holy ministry this day. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord. Trust in the Lord, and he will protect you. In Jesus' name, amen. Christian Kojo Voleto, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Be a blessed man who will take refuge in him. Amen. Kingsley Yesulagbe, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you into ministry. May the Lord who has called you sanctify you through and through. May he give you fresh enablement for ministry work. In Jesus' name, amen. Faith Zanu, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you this day into the holy ministry. Trust in the Lord. Lean not on your understanding. Depend on him at all times. Be attentive to his words. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray. Father, Thank you for the lives of your children who have been commissioned as new people, reverend ministers. May your strength come upon them. Bless them and lead them in Jesus' name. Now may the peace of God, which passes every understanding, rest on you, give you enablement in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you very much, Moderator. Oh, mia ga kwa kwe wa se o mia kwa o plakwe, mia kwa o plakwe, mia kwa o plakwe, mia kwa o plakwe. Thank you very much. Mia da kwe. Within. Mia de kukuna evuya kulao, alo evuya to, mo ilefmia. Abe mi hemona bubu opeyi tamia addo akpede ameyole pepede miangu bebu na watengwai GE710617 and GT2487X is a taxi GT2487X. Miangu, Bemia Nagami, Fifia Mia Biacho, Hama Peloya, Odo Metode Cassi, Bawava, Academia Novioke, Gio Dacido Egbea, Bawa Daci, Agbalete, Enye, Esse Pewona, Pacba Veve Tode. Now we invite Lawyer Jesse Haibo to lead us as our licentiates sign the formula. Thank you. Shall we welcome her? Mia Hwe Plakbe.
Reverend Harrison Adoblosu. Yao Adome.
Okay.
Reverend James Agbeko. Reverend Patrick Agbema BRC. Reverend Michael Kosit Kudaya. Reverend the Lady. Carlos. Carlos. Badago. Reverend Augustine, sir. Reverend Simon Setrafia. Reverend Christian Voleto.
Thank you very much. Thank you, church choir. Thank you, lawyer Jesse Haibo. Shall we now put our hands together as our pastors take their seats? May I bring the moderator back for the last activity? Thank you.
Beloved in the Lord has enabled the Global Evangelical Church to grow from strength to strength, to witness to people, and also to acquire properties. Among others, we acquired a property which we call the Nungwa property. We've had some challenges in the use of the property, but we are stewards and we ought to be faithful. Challenges are part of life, and we have to learn to stand up to any such challenge, whether it be in the life of an individual, a family, or the church. The Synod Committee realizes the need to put together a management team to advise, to see to the issue of the Nungwa property. And today I want to mention their names at this gathering and also commission them to do that. The people are Mr. Vincent Kanleji. I would require of them to come forward. He is the chairman of the committee. He's a businessman. Most of you know him. Mr. Carl Bangini. He's a member of this congregation. Mr. Jonathan Akwa. He's a lawyer. Mr. Carl Bangini. I didn't want to make a mistake. I wanted to say an engineer, an architect. Mrs. Doris Agbesinyale. She's largely into development. And the popular Captain Daniel Denu. I say the popular Captain Daniel Denu because he has been involved in a number of things in this church. And, he's not around today. Okay. Yes. I have given the description already. These 2 years, the theme is faithful stewardship. We acquired that property. God allowed us to do so. When God allows you to do something, at the time of doing it, if God did not prevent you from doing it, He has a purpose for you. And so we are this day giving you charge to look at the property, advise and lead. Tell us what we should do. Tell us what you intend to do so that we will use that property. The chairman, as I said, is Mr. Vincent Kanleji. So, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and by the authority of the Synod of the Global Evangelical Church, I commission you to do this. May the Lord be your strength to guide and to protect you, to give you wisdom and enablement. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you very much.
Shall we have the moderator for the closing prayer and the benediction? Mia anochitre aho nubedududa kule ya ira.
Mia wunu kule afeto fe gbedududa be miato siele jipo won kontina ko won fiat fe naba. Mia wolonu la nyi baji. Sibale si onele jipo ene. Na mia fe dudu si asumia nwegbelami. Chom mia fe nuvon kemi. Sigbalesi miyao ha. Mi chone ka mi fi udafde miyao ti laene. Mega plomi tete pomo. Ke de mi chou voni to la sime. El abena to wenye fiyaro. Ple un se, ple un ti kokwe. Yehu apa menu veve. Ni gbago nao. Ba o chogbe. Le wagbe me. Yehu ane ko odeji. Wa de futola fe nupe ka me oda le momen nao. Kristo fe vu. Vu ike fonu unye u abel to lane duji nao. Le Yesu Kristo fe nkome. Amen.
Closing hymn is 155. We're singing only in the first two stanzas. Mi ape nu ha nye alofa de kabla ton vaton. Kuku igban tople eveliako. Novio mi pa kunye o ziale sinudo ili. Iwo dole Yesu nkome. Basede si wagava. Eke mami aji. Nunge I hao. E mi achonu pupu o vene. Blessing you doily. Blessing you do. You will dole Yesu nkome. Basede si wagaba. Eke mami ajinu rei hao. E mi achonu poku o vene. Evelia abe mamleto fifia enye dowoyi. Miele akbagba jemda. Ne Yesu anabe. Via o akbefu afisia ha. Wakbefu la bakple jide poko. Agbagba jemda Ne Yesu anabe via o akpefu Ana via akpefu afisia ha Afisia akpefu la kwakple jide poko Ela be jijo ma vole ongo. Akpe, maone yura mikata.